Hello guys, this is first lecture on Bessel's function. So to understand Bessel's function, first we have to understand what is Bessel's equation. So the equation of the form x square d to y over dx square plus x dy over dx plus x square minus n square y is equals to 0 is known as Bessel's differential equation, and its particular solution is known as Bessel's function. Particular solution is in the form of series. That is, we have to apply the concept of series solution, and after applying series solution, and we get a solution which is known as Bessel's function. So where, what is the use of this Bessel's equation? This is used in oscillatory motion of a hanging chain, Euler's theory of a circular membrane, a study of planetary motion, propagation of waves, elasticity, fluid motion, potential theory, cylindrical and spherical waves, theory of plane waves, and etc. and etc. This is also known as cylindrical and spherical function. So, to find the series solution of this particular equation, we have to first identify whether there are ordinary point or singular point. So, here singular point exists. Which point exists? Singular point exists. And when singular point exists, we have to apply Frobenius method. After applying Frobenius method, we get initial equation, and initial equation will be m square minus n square is equals to 0. So from here we get to root m equals to plus minus n, and roots are distinct and differ by an integer, then its complete solution will be y equals to c1 y at m1 plus c2 del y over del m at m2. That is, this is of third case of series solution. For the detailed solution, you can visit my lecture which is in the description box, and also you can see the lecture number 4 of the series solution. So from there you can get how to find the solution. And now we are processing directly the series solution of this Bessel's equation. Or we can write the series solution in the form sigma r equals to 0 to infinite a naught x raised to power n into minus 1 power r x raised to power 2r upon 2 raised to power r into r factorial 2 raised to power r n plus 1, n plus 2, up to n plus r, or in the form y equals to a naught x raised to power n sigma r equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power r upon r factorial n plus 1, n plus 2, up to n plus r into x upon 2 power, because this is 2 raised to power r, 2 raised to power 2 raised to power 2r, and x raised to power 2r, so we can write it as x by 2 power 2r. This particular solution is known as Bessel's function. If we put a naught is equals to 1 upon 2 raised to power n gamma n plus 1, or 1 upon 2 raised to power n into n factorial, and this Bessel's function is represented by j n x. So this y will convert into j n x, and which is equals to sigma r equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma n plus r plus 1 x by 2 power n plus 2r, and its extended form is jnx is equals to x raised to power n upon 2 raised to power n into gamma n plus 1 into 1 minus x square upon 2 into 2n plus 2 plus x raised to power 4 upon 2 into 4 into 2n plus 2 2n plus 4 and so on. That is, this condition can be found from this particular equation. When we put a naught equals to 2, 1 upon 2 raised to power n gamma n plus 1, and on simplifying, then we can get this particular equation. And now, from here, if we put n equals to 0, some deductions are, if n equals to 0, then j0x is equals to upon gamma 2, which is equals to 1 factorial, and 1 minus x square upon 2 into 2, plus x raised to power 4 upon 2 into 4 into 2 into 4, and so on. Or we can write it as j0x is equals to 1 upon 2, gamma 2 is 1 factorial, that is 1. So, leave it 1 minus x square upon 2 square plus x raised to power 4 upon 2 square into 4 square minus x raised to power 6 upon 2 into 4, 2 square into 4 square into 6 square and so on. So, this is the first deduction. And similarly, when we put n equals to 1, then another deduction will arise. And when we put n equals to minus n, that is at n equals to minus n, then j minus nx is equals to sigma r equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma minus n plus r plus 1 x by 2 power minus n plus 2r. So, this is the another function of this particular jnx. Now, taking one question, show that Bessel's function jnx is an even function when n equals to even and is odd when n equals to odd. If f minus x is equals to fx, then even, and if f minus x is equals to minus fx, then odd. So, we will have to use this particular condition. So, solution from jnx, which is equals to sigma r equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma n plus r plus 1 x by 2 power n plus 2r. Let it is equation number 1. On putting x equals to minus x, then j n minus x is equals to sigma r equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma n plus r plus 1 minus x by 2 power n plus 2r. It is equation number 2. Now, case first. When n is equals to even, then n plus 2r is also even. It means minus x by 2 power n plus 2r can be replaced by x by 2 power n plus 2r. So, jn minus x is equals to sigma r equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma n plus r plus 1 x by 2 power n plus 2r. But this is the formula of jn. So, jn minus x is equals to jnx. It means it is even a function when n is equals to even. Now, case second, if n equals to odd, it implies n plus 2r is also odd. So, it implies minus x by 2 power n plus 2r can be written as minus x by 2 power n plus 2r. So, from this equation number 2, jn minus x is equals to minus sigma r equals to 0 to sigma r equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma n plus r plus 1 into minus x by 2 power n plus 2r. Now, take this minus outside, then this entire function will convert into jnx. So, jn minus x is equals to minus jnx when n equals to odd. It means this is a odd function. So, we have proved this particular phenomenon. Hope you understand the content of this lecture. If you like this lecture, then like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.